Hello and welcome to this video on implementation of DNNs using Python. I am Ritik and this Jupyter notebook is created by my colleague Mansi. Let's begin this video and now let us just see the outline for this our Jupyter notebook or IPython notebook. Here we are in the Google Collaboratory environment where we will be running this IPython notebook. And okay, let's just see the outline first. Here first we will be generating the data which is not linearly separable. Then we will train our sigmoid neuron and check its performance. Then we will build from scratch or code from scratch our first feed network or the FF network. Then we will train our FF network on the data and compare it with that of a sigmoid neuron. Then we will write a generic class for our FF network. Then we will train up that particular generic class for a binary classification purpose, and then we will generate the data for the multi-class classification purpose. Okay, so let's begin this. First, we will be importing our packages. Here we will be using NumPy as np, matplotlib for plotting, sklearn is scikit-learn library, and here we are importing its model selection for train trace split. This helps us in order to split our data. Then also we will be using metrics for accuracy square and accuracy score and mean square error. Then we will be using pre-processing for one hot encoders, and we will be using its data set as well. So okay, in order to run a file either on a Jupyter notebook or in a Google Colab, the thing we do is we just click on this play button and it runs it automatically. So okay, before we start training our data on the sigmoid neuron, we will build our model inside a class called sigmoid neuron. So this is our very class that we have defined as a sigmoid neuron, and this also we did in our very last presentation or video on sigmoid neuron when we were seeing that implementation of our sigmoid neuron. So see, as we have defined here the initialization or init function, then we have defined the perceptron function which returns the dot product of the inputs and the weights. Then we have defined the sigmoid function here. Similarly, we have defined grade w function, that is gradient, where that is we are updating here gradients using mean squared error loss. Then we will be updating the gradient using cross entropy loss, where, and then we will be then using the fit method. This model fit methods is where we define the number of epochs where we iterate over our data. So here, as we can see, first we have initializing our weights and biases, then we have started iterating it first, where here number of epochs are defined very specifically, and then we will start. Well, then we will be seeing here display for our very loss which we have as mean squared error. Then also we will be predicting, we will be using this predict function, so it will return a NumPy error of y prediction. Okay, so we will also run this particular cell. We'll have to run cell in a particular manner since we have already imported this NumPy and matplotlib and all these libraries. So here this cell is being run here, as you can see. So now let's move on in generating our data. So now we will be creating our own color map for our better visualization. So we are using here matplotlib and we are using linear segmented color map here, and we will be using colors red, yellow and green which we have specified here. So let's run this cell. Then we will be generating 100 observation with 4 layers, which is actually a multi-class. So here we can see, and now we will be printing data.shape and label.shape so that we can see the dimension for our data and labels. So we have see around 1000 samples and we have around 1000 labels as well. Okay, let's move on. Now let's visualize our data. So as you guys can see here, we have plotted the data and you can see 4 colors here: green, then red, then orange is here, and here we can see a light green color is there as well. Now we will be converting the multi-class classification here to just binary classification. In order to do that, we will be using the same matplotlib, and here as you can see, now from four classes here we have just two clusters, maybe three clusters left here, but the data is basically red and green only. That is yes or no type. We have converted our data into binary. Now we will be splitting this binary data with the help of trend test split from our sklearn or scikit-learn library, and see, we were successful in splitting this data in 75% and 25%, where 75% is training data and 25% is testing data. So now we will move on to our SN classification or sigmoid neuron. See, as we have created the object for our very class that we defined earlier on. Now we will train the model. Here we have set our number of epochs as 1000 and our learning rate as 0.5. So this thing will take a bit of a time. Let's wait a bit. As you all can see here, we are successfully done with training our model, and here our plot is plotted against mean squared error versus the number of epochs. Since we have used 1000 epochs, and this error become very much constant of around 0.275 here. So now let's write the prediction on training data and on testing data with these few lines of code using sn.predictxtrain and sn.predictxvalue, where xvalue we defined as our testing data or validation data. Now let's see what accuracy it turns out to be. As we can see, the training accuracy is 0.73 or 73%, and the validation accuracy is 0.71%. So now let's visualize our results. So again, in order to run this, so as you can see here, we have been So as you can see here, a plot is here, which basically it is a graph where we have that red dots and green dots respectively. So now let's define the first feed, now our first feed forward network or the FF network. So okay, how we will be going to define this FF network? We will be using it as a class. So we will be first defining class and then defining its function within. So init function is same, where we have initialized 6 weights and 3 biases. Then we will move on to defining the sigmoid functions, which is as usual. Then we will be defining this very forward pass function, where we will be using pre-activation and activation. Then we will be defining the back propagation. See, this basically everything here is in form of a NumPy, and we are using here NumPy and the same formulas which we discussed earlier. Just instead of the equations, we are writing a particular code here, and the code really is very simple, and it basically is the same thing what we have written. Say if we say a1, which was the pre-activation function, then we would be doing was w1 times x1 plus w2 times x2 plus p1. So the same plainly what we written in maths, the same thing we are writing here, and that's where Python comes up very handy. As you can see here, you can clearly see we have what formula or what function was particularly defined for activation function a1 is same with this line of code. Similarly, we will go on and define back propagation in a very particular, in a very similar manner as we have seen in the very previous video, which we do mathematically. Here we have just done the very same thing. So now we will be initializing our weights and biases, and see what we here we are doing is random dot rand n function. So what it basically does is activates or initializes our weights randomly. This thing is very helpful. in order to get a very better accuracy, and NumPy helps us to randomly initialize our weights using this very particular function, and we will be initializing our biases as zero, and then we will be iterating our epochs as we did earlier in our case of a sigmoid neuron, and then we will be seeing again the same thing which we did, and we will be displaying our loss and predicting the value. So okay, let's go on and run this particular cell of ours where we have defined our FF neuron. So okay, let's move on and train this model on our FF neuron network. Let's wait till it's being trained. So you can see it is being trained of around 16% now. We'll be waiting it. This particular thing for prediction that we, in this particular case, we have taken 2000 epochs with a learning rate of 0.01. Here learning rates comes very handy, and here learning rate of 0.01 means we are pursuing or seeking for an accuracy of 99%, and we are also displaying the loss here, and all these lines of code are same that we did earlier for our sigmoid function. And again we will be having here it will output both our training accuracy and validation accuracy. So as you can see, we are done with our training, and the training accuracy has turned out to be 0.67 and validation has turned out to be 0.66. it is a bit low in here, but as we go on and use better functions, we will be seeing that accuracy goes high. So let's visualize this prediction. So yeah, you can see all here that this plot is a bit different from the what we defined when we used our sigmoid function here. As you can see, this red plot is upper, say if we just divide it diagonally, so in this particular triangle part, you can see the left part of the triangle was red, very much clearly defined, and this left right angle triangle was green. This isn't the case when we have defined our FF network and when we have trained it. So in this particular case, see, the right upper right triangle has been green and the lower triangle has been red. So okay, let's move on to the generic class for FF neural network. So here we have defined that FFS network. So same things what we did here for neuron and FF network, now we are doing the same thing for FF neural network. We will be defining the sigmoid function, initializing function. I'm skipping this part as we have already discussed this in the almost every class we have defined, and they are basically the same, no changes in here except for the formula that we basically use for defining these networks. So let's move on, and now we will go on and training it with two hidden layers we have used. This is the main important point, which had the particular first layer has two neurons and the second one has three neurons. See, we want to search for this particular thing, we will be specific in defining our network in that particular way. So here, as you can see, we have used the same epochs, and we have again, in order to display that loss, we have iterated over the same epochs. And so now as we go on, see, we can see it is about 59% completed our training. Let's wait for it to get it completed. The mean square error is what we have defined for our loss. So let's wait till our training is completed, as we are using GPUs here, so the training is particularly a bit faster because Google provides that GPU access to us. So we can use the same thing with Jupyter notebooks as well, but then we will have to reconfigure it in a particular way to use the GPUs. Okay, we are done with the training. This particular graph shows the same thing. Here we have trained it on 1000 epochs with learning rate of 0.001. This is 3.0. सी 0.999%, 99.9% एक्यूरेसी इज़ वॉट वी आर सीकिंग हियर, विच इज़ रियली वेरी गुड. सो ओके, लेट्स मूव ऑन एंड नाउ वी विल बी सीइंग वॉट एक्यूरेसी इट टर्न्स आउट टू बी. इट टर्न्स आउट टू बी 73% ट्रेनिंग एक्यूरेसी एंड 72% इज दैट ऑफ अ टेस्टिंग एक्यूरेसी और वैलिडेशन एक्यूरेसी. सो इट इज़ क्लियरली ग्रेटर दैन FF network and which also seems to be around bit equal to our sigmoid. So okay, let's move on to multi-class classification with the FF network. So here we have using this one hot encoder which we have imported from our scikit-learn library. So after using this one hot encoder, we will be printing the shape of our labels, or sorry, training shape and testing or validation shape, which turns out to be 750 and 250, 75% and 25% separation of data, with 4 being the second part of the dimension. So we will be defining once again our FFS and multi-class. Here what we are defining here is number of inputs, number of outputs, and hidden sizes in our initial function, and the rest is defined same, except we have added here softmax function and cross entropy and gradient as we are using as, and then the fit function is also defined in the similar way with nothing added to it. So let's go on and train our model on multi-class classification. So as you can see, the model is being trained here, and let's wait for it to train. Here we are using 2000 epochs and learning rate is 99.005, which means that we are aiming for 99.5% accuracy, or that is what we will try to achieve. So a question might arise in your mind that why are we varying the number of epochs? Sometimes we are using 2000, sometimes in training we are using 1000, sometimes we are changing this learning rate. Actually, we all play or change this epochs and learning rates and then test and check whether the accuracy increases or decreases or how it varies. So that it's basically try and error thing. So it's mostly general. That if we have total number of data points less, since in this case we have only 1000 samples, so we can run say 2000 epochs on it, but say when we have a million data samples, then we cannot say use this much high number of epochs, because the memory we will be using will be very very high, so it is not physically possible for our computers or to work on it. So what we do in that very case, the number of epochs becomes very less, say 3 or 5, and the learning rate also, say it's normally defined as 0.1, but as in this particular case we have only 1000 points, so we can really play with it. You can go on and edit this particular notebook, change this learning rate and epochs, and try it out yourself, that see if you get a better accuracy than we get in this particular video at this particular point of time. And our main aim is to increase accuracy both in video our training data and the validation data. So let's see here, as we are about 0.94% done here, so let's see what accuracy turns out to be. So yeah, we are done, and this is particular plot, and as you can see the variation of CE here with respect to the number of epochs is very very high and it is fluctuating very fast. But a plus point we all can see here and why we done this is, see, the training accuracy has gone to 0.88 or 88%, and validation accuracy is 89%, which is the highest in all the three cases that we see. And here maybe task may be different here, but see, the accuracy is very good. Normally this kind of accuracy is considered to be really very great. But as we can see that the number of samples were a bit less, so we can get this accuracy here. So come on, let's visualize this plot. And you can see here we have particularly changed it into the four classes, as you can see, green, light green, and red and orange. So we will conclude this, as we have built a simple neural network from scratch and seen that it performs well with our sigmoid neuron, couldn't handle it non-separable data, then we will be using a generic class which has n number of inputs and l number of hidden layers for binary classification and mean squared error as loss function. Then we extended our generic class to multi-class classification using our softmax function, as we said, we defined earlier, and we have discussed this very softmax function theoretically as well in our previous videos, and cross entropy as a loss function, and saw that performance went to 88 and 89% from what it was 69% and 73% of accuracy. So we are defining our very performance on the very criteria of our accuracy, both training and validation. So yeah, thank you for watching this video.